So here's a pretty standard little while loop thingy to do. So go ahead and try this. So basically what you want to do is you want to ask the number to guess a secret number, or sorry, ask the user to guess a secret number from 1 to 10. And then like you're going to know what the number is. So like, you know, you'll have like, okay, this is my secret number. My secret number is 3. Guess my number. And then they'll try to guess it, except you won't have told them. But anyway, I want you just to keep asking until they get it right. So this is really, really straightforward, theoretically straightforward while loop problem. So go ahead and give this a shot. Pause the video and see how far you can get. So we'll pretend that's happened. Okay, ask the user to guess a secret number. So the first thing I need to do is I'm going to keep my secret number, and I'm going to call my secret number 5. So so there's a couple ways you can do this. You can either start off by asking the user what their number is, but the thing is you've got to remember there's got to be a way that you can get into the loop in the first place. So you could say, you could call something guess, and you could say, guess my number. And then you could say, while the guess is not equal to my secret number, then I want to keep asking. And this should be relatively straightforward. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna run this. Guess my secret number. Done. Okay. Beautiful. And you might say, well, rather than having them guess your number right off the bat, what you could do is you could change this first line and you could initialize it to like, you know, negative something, like something that's clearly not going to be the answer. Or like pi, like my secret number is clearly not going to be negative pi. So there's no really reason I picked that. It's just random. Okay. Arbitrary. E or whatever. There. This is not going to be my secret number. So I'll set that as a fake initial guess, and then it will then come through and ask. So this is like I said, a relatively straightforward problem. So if you had trouble with this, you want to probably go review some of the other videos or find other videos related to while loops to make sure that you can do something like this, at least to get started. Okay, the next thing that you want to try to do, and again, to do it on your own time, is to keep track of how many times they ask and stop whenever they've guessed like 10 times, I guess. I don't know. So whenever they've guessed 10 times, then get out of the loop. And we've actually talked about how to do that, but there's a way to do it without knowing the official way, and then I'll show you the official way. So again, pause the video, see how far you can get. Okay, we'll pretend that happened. Now, so in order to do this, what I need to do is start keeping track of the number of guesses that they have. So I need to start with num guesses equals 0. So the way I've had this set up, they haven't actually guessed yet because that's my fake guess. Okay, so after they guess, then I have to increase the number of guesses equals num guesses plus 1. So now I've guessed more times. So once I've guessed the first time, so this is important to get the order on this right, okay? Because I've guessed, then I increase the number. So it started at 0 and now it's 1. So after I've guessed one time, the number of guesses is 1. We want to make sure this works. So guess my number, I'm going to guess 3. It says you've guessed once. Okay, so that's working. So if I put the guesses line before the guess, then I'm actually kind of off. But now I'm good. So that took me 4 guesses. Okay, so now what I can do is I can say, well, if the number of guesses, so if I've guessed, what did I say, 10 times? If I guessed 10 times, and let me just make this number smaller. I'll just say guess 3 times. So if I've guessed 3 times, then I want to say, oh no, it took too long. And then I want to get out of the while loop. So I don't want to do this anymore. Now, one way to do it is to set guess equal to my secret number, because then it will, because then it will automatically. So if you did this, then that will work. So let me show you. So I'm guessing wrong, guessing wrong, guessing wrong. And it says, oh no, I took too long. It changed the guess to the secret number and it got out. Now that's really not the best way to do this. So let me show you the better way to do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to say break. Okay. And what break is going to do is it's going to break out of, whether you're in a for loop or a while loop, it's going to get out of it, fundamentally get out of it. So it's like, okay, we're not doing this anymore. Okay, so now I'm gonna run it and say 1, 1, 1. Oh no, it took too long, got out. Okay. Now here's the only problem with this, and you might have already noticed. If I go 1, 1, 5, and I get it right, it still yells at me. So I might need to add something to this if statement to say like, and if the number of guesses is 3 and I'm still wrong, then I want to say, oh no, it took too long. So I could say 1, 1, 5. Now it doesn't yell at me anymore. And I could just say, I don't know. So if I really wanted to, I could actually have something in here that said, if I get a guess that is equal to the secret number, then I could say, great job. And if they got it, did a great job, then again, it's gonna break automatically, so I don't really have to worry about it, but it would come out. So what's my secret number? 113, nope, took too long. 115, great job. Okay, so that was fun. Now there's one more thing we can do, is we can actually edit this to say, well, if you don't guess a number between 1 and 10, then we're gonna ask you to keep guessing, but we're not gonna count it against you. Does that make sense? Okay, so this is gonna require a little bit more work. So I'm gonna say this again. Since I wanted a number from 1 to 10, then obviously if you guess a 0 or if you guess a 11, then that's a dumb number. So we're not gonna count it against you. So what I could have in here is I could say if the guess is less than or equal to 0, or if the guess is greater than or equal to 11, then what I could do is I could say guess must be between from 1 to 10. And whenever I say the guess must be from 1 to 10, hi kitty, then what I could do is something called continue. Now what continue does is it actually says, well, forget about the rest of this while loop. Go ahead and just start over at the beginning of the while loop like nothing happened. So I'm going to show you what this does. So if I guess 0, it just keeps asking. So even though I'm supposed to stop guessing or stop asking after I've had 3 guesses, I'm making that like 3 legitimate guesses. So now I have a legitimate guess and a legitimate guess and a legitimate guess, and then it just says I took too long. So notice that we do this before we increase the number of guesses, and that's more just how we decided to play our game thing, in that we don't want to punish them for having too many guesses if they didn't understand the rules. So we'll say, well, if they don't guess right, then we're not going to increase the number of guesses. We're just going to go back to the beginning of the while loop and have them guess again. So this is a really, really kind of standard thing that you would do with a while loop.